year.
That's good.
So activity expected to pick up today, though, and we did have some severe weather out across the plains yesterday. Nothing too problematic. This morning on the WLWT radar, dry conditions locally, and then as we look off to the west a little broader, we do have a shower or two across portions of Indiana, and can't rule out this morning we'll likely have some extra clouds around sunrise and maybe a sprinkle or a light shower possible, but I think it'd be very isolated, so not too much to be worried about. In general today, we'll be watching activity off to our west that will not make it into the tri-state, so you can likely plan on a dry day, especially during the day period between the morning hours until about 9 o'clock this evening. Here's the city cam downtown right now with the dry pavement. Visibility is high. The temperature has dropped back into the mid-50s. Not too cool for the morning hours. The average low is about 47, so I don't think we'll quite get that low, but right now at 53, a northeast wind at 12 miles an hour, and the visibility is high at 10 miles. On the satellite and radar, some showers during the night from Missouri sparking up into Illinois towards Chicago. Nothing for us at this point, but we do have a couple of clouds approaching. I think we'll see more general clouds around today than yesterday. And at times, they may kind of dim our sunshine, help keep our temperature down just a couple of degrees compared to yesterday. We did make it to 80 for a high on Saturday. So I think today we're looking at some mid-70s. Quiet conditions this morning, and as we head into our afternoon, some thunderstorms approach from the west, but don't quite make it into the tri-state. We likely stay dry today thanks to that front that kind of sunk a little bit farther south during the overnight, and high pressure behind it just enough to bring us an easterly wind and dry conditions today. But as that front lifts back north this evening, we do bring back the chance for storms after about 9 or 10 o'clock tonight. The farther west you live, a shower or storm already possible, and then spreading across the region through the night into tomorrow morning. Some local downpours, maybe some hail mixed in into Monday morning's commute. Then Monday afternoon, a little bit quieter. We do have some general pop-up afternoon activity, but I think we'll also see some breaks and some dry periods on Monday. And then Monday evening, we return with another chance for storms, and this one a little bit better chance for maybe some strong to severe thunderstorms. Our main threat would be some damaging winds and some large hail. The better chance for tornadic activity with severe weather is situated comfortably to our southwest, down across portions of Arkansas into Tennessee. So we're definitely not in a prime location for that, but we do have the chance for continued severe weather for Monday evening into Tuesday morning, and we'll stay with the off and on stormy pattern through Tuesday, and then as we make it into Wednesday, we transition to mainly showers. So today's activity does look like a moderate chance for severe weather from Missouri into Arkansas, and that does have the chance for some strong thunderstorms with possibly some large tornadoes. Then as we head into tomorrow, we're in a slight risk for general severe storms. The moderate risk is from Nashville, Tennessee to the south, and the tornado threat has lowered just a bit as we head into Monday. 74 degrees for a high today, partly cloudy skies, an east breeze. Then for our overnight, rain overspreading. We drop off to 56, and tomorrow we top out at 74. More activity for Monday, widespread storms in the morning and evening. Activity on Tuesday, still 75. Then temperatures start to drop back, highs in the low 60s, and some showers off and on, especially evening showers Thursday, and that also lasts until